We have been in some incredible sets over the years on Harry Potter, and this has to be up there with the best of them. This is Gringotts, the Wizarding Bank, and we're in the Lestrange Vault.
박진감 넘치는 장면이 연속인 죽음의 성물 2부의 돌부였죠. 오늘은 그린고트 잠입신 비하인드를 소개해드리도록 하겠습니다.
Getting into Gringotts is a dangerous thing, so they naturally have to disguise themselves. Harry and Griphook, who goes along with them, go under the invisibility cloak. Ron puts on a disguise, some makeup, a beard, etc. And Hermione, if you remember the end of the last film, a hair drifted down to her when she was in Malfoy Manor. And she takes that hair and she puts it in some polyjuice potion and she drinks it, though we don't see her, that's done off camera, and she becomes Bellatrix.
Gringotts Bank is obviously a huge undertaking. Harry and Hermione and Ron are there with Griphook, and they're breaking into Gringotts to see if there's a Horcrux in Bellatrix's vault.
Madam Lestrange.
Good morning.
It's a pretty daunting adventure. Ron's disguised as the Death Eater.
He looks fantastic.
So, with the help of a bit of makeup, actually we have a really strong character.
감독과 프로듀서들이 장면을 설명해주는 인터뷰였는데요. 그린고트 잠입신이 어떤 장면인지 설명해줍니다. 도비의 희생으로 말폴 저택을 간신히 탈출한 해리 일행은 빌과 플레리가 살고 있는 조개비 오두막으로 몸을 피하게 됩니다. 해리는 호크룩스 중 하나가 벨라트릭스의 근거에 있다는 걸 느끼게 되죠.
Let's find it, kill it, and then we're one step closer to killing him.
그린고트로 몰래 숨어 들어가기 위해 해리와 그리프군 투명망토 아래에 숨고 헤르미온느는 폴리주스를 사용해 벨라트릭스로 변했으며 로는 죽음을 먹는 자로 분장합니다.
Hey, Rube, how you doing?
Good to see you. I have to say, this is just quite unexpected.
How is it?
Good looking, isn't it?
Yeah, it's all right. It's itchy, but...
Does it take a while to get on?
It takes about an hour, yeah.
Explain what's going on in this scene.
This is like kind of the carts that go through all the kind of underground...
Through the vaults and down to get to
them. Yeah. So yeah, it's good. It's quite fun on this one.
It's quite a good laugh being up there on the rig as well.
It is actually, yeah, it's quite good.
Quite enjoyed all those scenes where we're all kind of disguised and stuff. It was basically, it's a full beard and Gary Oldman's old wig, I think. They darkened my eyebrows and it was quite strange. Like, people I've known for like years kind of just walked past me and didn't have a clue who I was.
Did you recognize him?
Brilliant. No, I didn't actually recognize him at first. I thought like a death eater had walked on.
It was quite fun. But it was quite a weird scene to get your head around.
로는 죽음을 먹는 자처럼 보이게 하려고 검은색 옷을 걸치고 메이크업으로 얼굴에 변화를 줬다고 하네요. 특히 시리우스 블랙 역을 맡았던 게리 올드만이 썼던 가발을 썼다는 점이 재밌네요. 같은 가발인데 완전히 다른 느낌입니다.
I'll try and make things simple because it's confused enough. I'm Helen Longpotter and I come to Harry Potter and they pay me to pretend to be Bellatrix. Now, I got to pretend to be Hermione pretending to be Bellatrix.
David really wanted me heavily involved in helping Helena really become me. The way that Helena works as an actress is that she takes research for a character really seriously. So she'd just sit and ask me question after question after question about Hermione in the most crazy details.
Emma Watson is Helena Bonham / Bellatrix Lestrange. Ready to go.
We had a session with Helena and Emma in a big rehearsal room where Emma basically did the scene. We said, okay, Emma, just show us how you'd walk up to the bank teller, what you'd say to him, how you'd say it.
I hardly think that would be necessary. I've never been so self-aware the way Helena was going, you know you do this? And I was like, I had no idea I did that. Like, when I laugh, I gasp for air, and I'd never realised I did that before. Or, like, I'm doing it right now. I play with my hands a lot, which I never realised. But these are all traits that obviously come out in Hermione because I'm playing her.
She gulps before each. It's like she's drowning.
겉모습은 벨라트릭스지만 내면은 헤르미온느이기 때문에 헬레나가 헤르미온느인 척하는 벨라트릭스를 연기해야 했습니다. 노래로 치면 원작 가수를 따라하는 모창처럼 동료 배우를 흉내내는 연기를 해야 했던 거죠. 그냥 단순히 똑같이 하는 것을 넘어 특징을 살려 자신의 캐릭터에 녹여야 하는 훨씬 더 복잡한 연기였다고 합니다.
But watching Helena do me was bizarre.
She's uncanny, isn't she?
She's uncanny.
Well, you can imagine. Hermione's Bellatrix, those are two quite different people,
yeah.
And it's not altogether comfortable for Hermione to be Bellatrix, to put it mildly.
I wish to enter my vault.
I was going to say, you're actually looking relatively demure. It's
well, I'm demure because actually I'm not Bellatrix today, I'm Hermione. This is Hermione's version of Bellatrix.
There's not enough leather for my liking.
No, because, you know, she's pure. She's not, well, Emma described her, because I got lots of notes. In fact, we could even see them on my text. She gave me some homework for how to play Hermione.
Did she?
Yeah, and she said prude, you know. We were sort of comparing the two, Bellatrix and Hermione. And when I got to play her, which is my life's dream, everyone wants to play Hermione.
Why not?
And it's great. Also, given that I am 43, to act opposite those two, because I now suddenly think, God, I'm 17 again. Let's see if I've got them on my... OK, Emma, thank you for being so sweet. Oh, later on. Definitely, I just really appreciate it. Oh, she's so nice to me. Hang on.
We are.
OK, then I ask for some more notes, and it's funny, I don't know where it's gone. At first, it was a bit nerve-wracking, because she hasn't got, you know, a hump. Emma. Or doesn't talk, or doesn't have a limp or something. She's much more introverted than Bellatrix, but there's a lot of worry going on, you know. And then she does this thing with, she does sometimes use her chin. That's my one,
she does.
It's like that. I'm sort of in Emma's mindset, so I'm thinking, okay, I've got to get into Gringotts. Are they going to recognise me? I'm thinking I mustn't blow it. So there's a lot of concern. So she's very serious, and she tries desperately hard, Hermione, because she always feels that she's not quite good enough.
She just gives herself a hard time, doesn't she?
She does give herself.
영화 볼 때는 이렇게까지 생각을 안 했었는데 이 장면에서 이런 복잡한 연기가 있었다는 걸 새삼 깨닫게 되네요. 다시 말해 자신의 캐릭터 외에도 10년 동안 동료 배우가 연기해온 캐릭터를 완벽히 분석하고 그 둘을 적절히 섞은 연기를 했던 거죠.
I think Hermione is kind of growing into her looks and kind of growing into her body, but I think she still feels insecure about it and she's kind of quite shy and quite almost prudish in a way. So to play Bellatrix, who has these amazing voluptuous breasts and she wears a corset and she's evil and she's a witch. I think she just feels really uncomfortable about the whole thing.
Not only is the tension of being in this really threatening environment, Gringotts not wanting to be exposed, but also there's the fact that Hermione just wouldn't want to be Bellatrix. She hates her. What she was trying to get across is how uncomfortable Hermione would be in Helena's body, because they are so different as people.
Yeah, no, that's good. That's very Emma-like.
And so you could see the awkwardness of Helena's walk in there, and I think it adds a strange tension and also some humour.
It was funny, it's sweet. It was... I really liked working with her.
It was quite amazing, really. She really got the kind of walk and the way Emma kind of speaks and stuff.
I hardly think that'll be necessary.
It's a role that has certain challenges, but Helena made a very good Emma, and it was quite charming, actually.
I don't like to be kept waiting.
Very well, Madame Lestrange.
You have to call me Emma.
I'm sorry, Emma.
배역에 집중하기 위해 엠마가 된 듯 생각하고 행동했다니 헬레나 보넴 카터가 대단한 배우인지 알았지만 이 어려운 걸 완벽하게 소화하는 걸 보니 정말 대단하네요. 배우 중 배우라고 불릴만 합니다. 엠마와 같은 젊은 배우들이 존경의 눈으로 봤을 것 같아요.
Action, Sherry. Action, take it. All right, here we go.
If it takes 2 to 3 people, makeup artists, to apply each of these makeups, you suddenly end up needing over 150 people.
Goodness me.
Just to get the makeups on in the morning. I had to bring in a load of makeup artists, some from Europe. I think we had 15 different nationalities all in one room, to get people who had the relevant skills and experience to be able to put these makeups on.
I'd imagine for the first time on set, you guys were the majority. The short actors were the majority, and that must have been quite strange, but quite satisfying.
Absolutely, yeah. There were more short people on set than certainly average-sized cast members, if not crew members as well. Yeah, and it was quite lovely because it's instead of feeling out of place, slightly on your own, you're suddenly surrounded by like-minded individuals and like-sized individuals, which was really quite fun.
고블린처럼 고난이도의 메이크업은 한 번 하는데 몇 시간이 걸렸으므로 하루에 모든 촬영을 끝내는 게 좋습니다. 그래서 이른 아침에 메이크업을 빨리 끝내고 촬영에 들어가는 게 아주 중요하죠. 이 때문에 150여 명의 메이크업 아티스트가 투입되었다니 우리 눈에는 보이는 것 이상으로 하나의 영화를 만드는데 많은 인원이 필요했네요.
Stuart, who designs the movies, was advising the Orlando theme park at the time.
Was he really?
I don't think there was a bit of cross-fertilization there. I'm sure he came back and he said, and the car kind of does that and then it goes around here. And I said, Stuart, this sounds great, but this is like, this is like a theme park ride.
What was that, Grip Hook?
And we actually see it when the film happens.
And Rupert as well, please.
To think we were right here. I love it. We've sort of seen a waterfall, and I've sensed that Warwick, as Grip Hook, is panicking. Grip Hook! And so we're just sort of desperately trying to work out why he is panicking, and as it turns out, it's because the waterfall which we then go under is something that removes all enchantments so that Helena then goes back to looking like Emma.
And then all hell breaks loose.
Do you know what? It just sounds like the average person trying to get a loan out of the bank at the moment. Do you know what I mean? There's all these...
That's what I love about Potter. It's entirely relatable.
영화로 결과물만 봤는데 이렇게 촬영장을 보니 기분이 색다르네요. 장면을 상상하고 그에 따른 감정을 몰입하여 연기하는 배우들과 CG 작업을 위해 며칠 밤을 새웠을 스태프들, 이 모든 걸 다 총감독한 감독과 프로듀서들의 노고라고 생각하니 앞으로 이 장면을 볼 때마다 이 메이킹 장면들이 생각날 것 같네요. 재밌게 보셨다면 구독과 좋아요 꼭 부탁드리고 더 궁금한 점이나 공유하고 싶으신 이야기가 있으시다면 댓글로 남겨주세요. 그럼 저는 최대한 빠른 시일 내로 유익한 영상으로 다시 돌아오겠습니다. 지금까지 우투비였습니다.